I just want you to make a hole like that in the melon skin, okay? Go on. Good.
I'm Ruby Rails, and this is Fast Forward Girls.
Okay, so I'm gonna look inside this box now. Whoa. I wonder what this cord's for. Ooh, cool scrubs. What do scrubs have to do with the VR set? An apple a day might keep the doctor away, but medical technology will keep your brain out of pain. I think that I might be meeting someone that does brain stuff. I don't know. Let's go see. Okay, so I'm walking up now. This is so cool. I'm so excited. I wonder who I'm gonna meet. Okay, so I'm about to go in.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm Saman Sizdakhani. I'm a neurosurgeon at Keck USC Medical Center.
What is neurosurgery again?
Neurosurgery is a field of surgery. Now, today we're learning about the brain, but I also do surgery on the spine. And neurosurgeons are really important when you get some sort of disease or problem with your brain or your spine, and you need to have surgery to take it out or fix the problem. I'm gonna focus on the things that we do on the brain today. Take away the skull, and inside you have the brain. It has the skull first and the dura second. This smooth covering is on everybody's brain. It's sort of like a protective layer. Now, if you were to break into the dura, you see we have this model that shows exactly what a brain looks like. You have two sides, or called hemispheres, just like you would in a globe. Every time I have to do surgery, we have to get the bone off to be able to work on the brain. Now, the procedure of getting the bone off is called a craniotomy. But if we were awake and open in somebody's brain, they wouldn't have any pain from working inside of it. So sometimes if somebody has a brain tumor in a very delicate part of the brain that's very important, for example, for language, then we do these surgeries with them awake.
Oh, wow, that's crazy. What is this stuff for?
This is the stuff that we need to do a craniotomy. So the most important thing in a craniotomy is to have a good working drill. This is our first drill bit, okay? And it's gonna help us make our burr hole.
How scary, and like, cause this is a real person you're working on.
That's right.
Like, if you hit it in the wrong spot, you could really damage something.
Absolutely. No matter what kind of doctor you are, it's something you have to think about, right? We have a saying in medicine called see one, do one, teach one. So you see it, be done, and then you do it. And once you do it, then you can teach other people how to do it.
Can we start?
Yeah, absolutely. We're gonna practice on the melon. We're gonna hold it like a pencil, okay? And I want you to practice holding it while you push your foot on that pedal, okay? And I want you to push all the way down on the pedal. Good, so that's all you need to do. I just want you to make a hole like that in the melon skin, okay? Go on. Good. Okay, now just hold it in place. All right, good, stop. Good. I want you to make a hole right around here. Good.
That was surprising.
Look, you did it perfectly. Now we're gonna use what's called a craniotome. The brain's down here, and the bone that we wanna cut comes through here. And so this foot plate protects the brain as we work so that you won't drill down into the brain.
Okay.
Lock the foot plate under the bone. When I say drill on, what we're gonna do is we're gonna connect the holes, okay? Drill on. Okay, stop. So that's how a craniotomy is done. You make multiple holes, and then you connect them all with this craniotome. I want you to make the hole here, and I want you to hold it. Good. And I want you to make a little circle. Just really gently indent the skull. And start to go deeper and deeper along that ridge you created. You're almost there. Keep going. Empty out those little bits of skull, okay? Good, you made it through. So you're gonna put the foot plate under the edge of the bone, and then you're gonna go straight across, okay?
Okay.
Push all the way on. Good, keep going. And then off. Good, you did awesome. That's so great. I'm really proud of you. I don't think I could have done that when I was 11. Let's finish the craniotomy. What I'm gonna do is connect all the holes so that we can get our piece of bone off. So push on. Okay, and look at that. Our dura is intact. Craniotomy complete. High five.
I did the whole thing.
You did.
I don't get to go into the school at all. Oh, I got a text message. You thought virtual reality was just a big game? You're about to learn what a life it can change. Thank you so much. I loved learning how to do brain surgery with you.
It's my pleasure. You did an excellent job.
So I just found my way to the next office.
I'm Suk Lee Lu. So I'm an assistant professor here at USC, and I am in the departments of occupational therapy, physical therapy, neurology, biomedical engineering, and neuroscience.
Oh my gosh, is that a 3D printer?
It is. What he has here is a brain. It's actually upside down. So
that's
a little bit
awesome.
Of brains and a little bit of arts and crafts.
Yeah, that's so cool.
We 3D print parts for the EEG cap.
Oh, like, that's so cool.
Yeah, so you said you've had EEG before.
Uh-huh.
We can 3D print these things and they hold different electrodes. So you can take that.
Whoa,
so that's 3D
so
printed.
Cool.
These are actually dry electrodes. So what we do is we put them on your skin or on your head and they'll make contact with your skin and they can actually read some of the electrical signals out of
that's
your
so
head.
So cool.
Yeah.
What does EEG stand for?
What do you think it stands for? Electro for electricity.
Electro.
And then encephalography. Which
okay,
is...
I wouldn't have been able to guess that.
Electro is electricity. Encepho is kind of like the brain. And then graphy, and that's like measurement. Essentially.
So Electroencephalography.
Mm-hmm, you got it, yeah. So it just stands for measuring brain activity. This is another example of what we 3D printed. So these black electrodes are the same things as these, but a little bit smaller. And then we actually 3D printed the case here. And this case holds this motherboard. You can think of it as a tiny computer. This is what's like recording the electrical signals and then sending it to another computer.
That's so cool.
Thank you. Do you want to try this on?
Yeah.
Oh, you got it.
Can I take a selfie with this on?
Of course. No one's ever asked me that before. Well, you're good at this. A brain-computer interface is whenever we take brain signals and try to use them to control a computer. Do you use Alexa?
Yeah.
So that's like a voice-controlled computer interaction. Brain-controlled computer interaction is similar, but instead of saying anything, you just think your thoughts and we read your brain activity, and we use that to control the computer. You're actually gonna help me to put this EEG cap on Octavio. Are you ready?
Yeah. We're gonna put a cap on you.
Nice.
These are what we call grounds. They just kind of ground the electrical signal, and you're gonna clip this on his earlobe.
Okay, I wanna start putting gel on.
Okay, all right, so just kind of, yep, swab away the hair. Good, until you can see his skin there. We're making a real mess of his hair, aren't we? All right, so now you're gonna put just a little bit so that it covers the surface. Good job. And then we're gonna put some Osol in here. This is the electrode itself, so fill that up.
Oh yay, all
the way, yep. Now, we're gonna put this like this. You have to get all 8 of these to turn green, and that's how we know that the electrodes are on his head and reading his signals. Good job. There you go, you've got one green one. All right, next. You look real determined when you do that.
Hold that. That's the third one.
Vigorously scrubbing the scalp. Octavia's gonna look like a mad scientist, I think, huh? Did you get it in there?
Nope.
You got it.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I filled that one a lot with the goop.
That's extra goopy.
Huh, this time I've gotta make it.
Let's wait a second and see what happens. All green!
I did it!
So if he closes his eyes or clenches his jaw, you can see it. So go ahead and clench your jaw really big, Octavio. And you'll see a little bit of noise. See, these are the jaw clenches.
Oh.
So each of these brainwaves, it represents millions cool. upon millions of neurons firing from each of these locations.
Cool.
Good job. So this is a VR headset. So we're actually gonna put Octavio in this. So we actually wrote a lot of software. So here he is in the beach, and we're actually gonna use the brain signals he has to control his virtual arm. And now we're telling him a beach ball is gonna come up and he has to move his hand to touch the beach ball using his brain activity here.
you so much. This was so fun, Dr. Lou.
You're welcome to come back whenever you want.
Hi!
I have to choose between these two people to be my mentor. We have Dr. Saman, and with her I learned how to do brain surgery, and Dr. Liu, and I learned about VR physical therapy with her.
Wow, that sounds super fun.
I think my advice would be to just do the one that was most fun and the one that you would want to do, because, you know, if you love your job and you love what you're doing, then that's the best.
Okay. Thank you.
Of course. Good luck.
Bye, Ruby.
Bye.
Hi, this is Bailey, and I had so much fun with you. I learned so much, and I want you to be my mentor.
Oh, I would love to be your mentor. You were an awesome helper today, and you did great. I would love to teach you more about what we do.
Do you think I could reach out to you if I ever have questions?
Of course. I would love to hear from you again.
Yeah, thank you so much. Bye.
Thank you.